Pitch on the ground to the right side. Bounces just over Mazzilli into right field. Coming around to score is Defoe. There will be no throw from Roach. And an RBI single here for Cody Gunder, his fifth RBI of the season. Scores Wilmer Defoe from second. And the Double Days take a lead here. It's 1-0 Auburn. King again still batting righty against the lefty Orland. Tiarina down at third, Mazzilli off first. The one-out pitch driven high out to left field. Allen and Ballou will converge in left center. Ballou will make the catch, but it's deep enough as Tiarina will come in to tag. Mazzilli trying to get to second. He'll get there as the sack fly works perfectly. Sack fly 8 for Jared King. Picks up his 8th RBI of the season, driving in Ismael Tiarina. And the Brooklyn Cyclones have tied up the Auburn Double Days. It's 1-1 here in the top of the third. Gieselman's stretched the 0-1 on the ground to first. Overstee will come home as Nito's tag is not in time. The tag could have been there. The throw was perfect from Overstee, but Nito couldn't swipe it down enough on Isaac Ballou. And just like that, on the fielder's choice, gets the runner in as Ballou scores, and it's a 2-1 lead now here for the Auburn Double Days. As that one bounces off the catcher, rolls towards the dugout, Overstee able to come in to score. As the wild pitch brings him in, and we're all tied up at 2. Once again, here in Auburn, 2-1 to Nito. Driven out to right center field, little drop in. Rounding third is going to be Roach. Just taking one base is Tomas Nito. The RBI single, and the Cyclones get ahead for the first time on the ballgame as Nito picks up his second RBI of the season. And the Cyclones ahead, now 3-2. 59th pitch here to the leadoff man. It'll be grounded just fair down the first baseline by the lefty swinging Wilmer Defoe. Into the corner, Roach will dig it out, but digging for third and going to get there, sliding in head first is Wilmer Defoe. He's got 2 extra base hits on the night and takes the first pitch here well into the right field corner. He was waiting on something, but that's the 5th hit of the ball game and a triple here for the Auburn Double Days to start things off. They trail here 3-2, but maybe not for long. Magliozzi hears the 1-2 pitch chop. Mazzilli will settle the fire to first. So it goes down as a ground out, 4-3, but an RBI here for Jimmy Yezzo. Brings in the runner Wilmer Defoe from third, and we're all tied up at 3. Tony Stretch, the 3-2 one-out pitch. On the ground to Tiarina. He'll scoop to Mazzilli for one on to first. Double play! As the call made by Mike Savakinis. So Minconi gets it done, inducing the 6-4-3 double play to end the frame here in inning number 6. 3-2 pitch, lifted into center field. Nobody is there, but King will drift over. He'll make the catch, but no chance to get the runner at home. Is streaking in from third, it's Cody Dent. And a sack fly RBI, which will be credited 7. For Wilmer Defoe as Dent comes in to score, and the Auburn Double Days come back and win this game 4-3.